Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Gavinski's Tutorials. Today I'm going to take a look at iPadOS 26 and ask, is this windowing feature that this now has useful for musicians, or are there any limitations? What are those? Long story short, it's promising, but I've run into some annoyances. So basically this allows you to use your iPad a lot more like a Mac. You know, you can have multiple apps open and you can move things around and resize apps, right? And a lot of things resize very well. For example, here I've got AUM, which is the host app that I normally use to, you know, load plugins on the iPad. So here I've got Moto Akami loaded in there and a few other plugins. And here I've got the Mogofogger filter. And if you notice here, this app, Ribbon, is modulating the cutoff frequency. So Ribbon is a really nice little app, but it's one that I have never used much because it's standalone. So one of the potential benefits of this new windowing feature is that you could start having AUM or another host open, taking like half the window, and then have this over here, because before AUM could not be used in split view. And this app, I can't remember if this could be used in split view. I think I only remember using it in slide over. So before I was able to use it in slide over AUM, but of course the problem with that was that it would obscure a lot of the screen, which is not really ideal. So this is working well, right? Fairly well, except I've run into some things. Like, for example, here, when I try to grab the edge of this window, I often start accidentally making this slider move, and that's not what I want. So I think that musicians could run into problems with that. You know, if you were trying to use a few different windows open in a live set, you might just accidentally do things that you don't want to do. But there are other issues I've run into. So the biggest problem is that although some apps resize very well, like AUM resizes great, a lot of apps don't. So for example, I really like these Sixual apps. And for example, this little MIDI controller here, Mills, I did a review on it recently. And it's great, but it's standalone, right? And so I was hoping that because we now have this windowing thing, that I could take this and, you know, reduce it so that it could take up half the screen. But you, as you can see, this is the smallest it will go, right? Like that's it full size, and then I drag in here, and this is as small as it will let me make it. Now I can drag it, like so it's kind of partly on the screen, but I can't have it just taking up half the screen as I was hoping for. So this is not the only app that I've run into this kind of thing with. Let's just close that there. For example, Synthesizer, another great MIDI controller app. I was hoping that I could open that half screen, but again, this is the smallest. This is at full, and then I drag in, and this is just as small as it will get. Drag down from here. Okay, let's see. Close window. Right. Another thing I ran into, for example, an app like Sculptor by Heinbach and Brambos. Now, this app can be used as a plugin, but, you know, I was just hoping that I could use that to demo this. And although this does resize very, very well, the problem here, for example, is that if you see up here, it even says for MIDI and audio connectivity, Load Sculptor is an AUV3 plugin. So the developer would have to add MIDI to the standalone app if I was going to use this in this way. Now again, I mean, I can open Sculptor in here as an AUV3. This is not a MIDI processor, it's just, it can be opened in a MIDI slot, but it's not in the MIDI processor list. So I can, of course, open this in here and I can use it as an AUV3. But the thing is that, you know, now it's blocking the screen there and it resizes and everything great. Although I'm finding that when I have AUM open small like this, it's very hard sometimes to grab the corner of apps to resize them. Like here I'm using the trackpad on my Bluetooth keyboard and that works absolutely fine. But if I try to drag this with my finger, like now I was trying and sometimes I get it and sometimes it just doesn't work. So, you know, there are definitely frustrations and limitations so far in my experience of all this. So I'm not really sure what is needed. You know, what would a developer like the synthesizer dev, what would they need to do to get this to resize more flexibly? Would there be much work involved? I don't know. Do you know? If so, write in the comments. Also, just mention, it has this now liquid glass thing. I don't know what you think about this, but I'm not a big fan of it. That said, I think that sometimes these things, they are really horrific when you first see them, and then over time you get used to them, and that's probably going to be the case here. Okay, everyone, I hope that was useful for you. Take it easy, and I'll see you in the next video.